Anti-government demonstrations grow increasingly more violent in Hong Kong. Clashes continue today between protesters and riot police outside a university. Police fired rounds of pepper balls and used tear gas to subdue protesters. Demonstrators were trying to escape from the campus of Hong Kong Polytechnic University to avoid arrest after barricading themselves inside the campus last week. Hong Kong has been rocked by anti-government protests for nearly 6 months. Joining me now by Skype from Hong Kong is Wilson Leung, a member of the Progressive Lawyers Group, a pro-democracy organization which advocates for human rights. Wilson, welcome back to the program. What are conditions like there in Hong Kong as we watch this tense standoff between police and demonstrators play out on the university campus?
We're seeing astonishing scenes of really a pitched battle. On the one hand, at the university itself, we see almost a military-style assault by the police against the university students who are barricading themselves inside. So we see the police with their, their weapons, their tear gas, rubber bullets, water cannon, and then the defenders inside with their petrol bombs and so on. But at the same time, we've got other many other protesters who are trying to come in from the surrounding areas in order to try to distract the police. And so we're seeing also lots of clashes in various areas of the territory around the university as well. So you've got a lot of clashes, a lot of fire, a lot of shots being fired this evening.
I can only imagine how scary it is to be there. There's another concern that we've been following. There's some concerns that were heightened over the weekend when soldiers from China's People's Liberation Army were spotted leaving their barracks unarmed and wearing civilian clothing to clean up debris on the streets. What does that signal to you? What do you think that's all about?
Yeah, I mean, that's certainly an alarming sight. Although their action itself appears harmless, it's actually of quite big constitutional significance. Because under Hong Kong's mini-constitution, it's quite arguable that the Chinese army is not supposed to intervene in local affairs. And in fact, they're not even supposed to participate in maintenance of public order or disaster relief unless requested to do so by the local Hong Kong government. And the local Hong Kong government have confirmed that they did not request any of this assistance. So it very much appears to be a very obvious and demonstrative sign that the PLA is here, is in town, and a worrying sign that they might be about to or willing to do further public appearances on the streets of Hong Kong, doing more than just clean up.
And if all of this wasn't bad enough, all of it's unfolding as Hong Kong's High Court on Monday struck down a ban on wearing face masks in public. How much of a blow is this to government leaders who wanted to ban face masks?
It's certainly a slap in the face because the government was heavily criticized when it used a law from 1922, basically which allowed her to do anything she wanted if she said it was an emergency. And she elected to use that power in order to ban face masks. And it was heavily criticized for its constitutionality. Right now, we saw the High Court striking down that law, agreeing with it. But for sure, the government is going to bring an appeal. And there's two more stages of appeal. And we've seen in recent years, the pattern that they have is that they throw unlimited resources into these legal battles. You can be sure that they're going to challenge it to the highest court.
We're also keeping our eye on elections this upcoming Sunday for Hong Kong as well. Wilson Leung of the Progressive Lawyers Group, thank you so much for sharing your insights and for joining us today.
Thank you.